someone comes in and then suddenly your job, you'll get more of those than you.
I heard this table earlier too, Julie was talking about simple, you know, that sounds so simple. Well, it doesn't have to be hard and complicated, that's the other misnomer. Oh, it's only gonna work if it's like this big dragon that we have to slay, it has to be, you know, years in the making and millions of dollars to be raised and then it's worthy. That's crap. You know, it comes, we're a community currency. It comes from good ideas, simply not a lot of money.
I just wanted to offer them, it's not always easy to know how to listen to your members or get a sense of what they're going to want to do or follow through on, and I want to just recommend Art of Hosting. You can go to their website and there are a lot of processes, like Action Cafes have been really helpful, World Cafes. So you can have these things emerge and you can learn what people want to have happen and then learn what they're willing to do and have a sort of a record of it that you can share out. And that can be, because it's not always easy, you know, you'll hear little ideas, this and that, but you never know until you get a little deeper into it.
It's a great idea that idea of hosting and just getting people in the room. Like, this was one time back here, you'd be surprised what you could do. In fact, we're all in different timelines, we're getting diverse ideas, but get people in the room and watch what happens. But having a forum, I think, is excellent.
So here's a closing story to sum it up, and because we believe everywhere we go, everything's integrated. You know, cues come up from wherever we are. Well, we'll meet somebody on the plane and find out they're going to be at the conference, you know, and find out they're actually going to be the next place we're going to, the person lives in the building. It just flows. So when I was getting the paper, the cover paper over the poster was about child care, early care and education, whatever you call it. I used to be a child care director for 10 years. So the story is, we had a center that served the kids nobody else would serve in the whole city. These were troubled kids in foster care, behavior issues, really poor. And we had a really horrible building that we'd inherited, and it was just awful. The basement was cold, not fine for kids. So we wanted to build a new building, we had zero money. I mean, zero money, plus trying to take care of it. There was a fire in the neighborhood. It was a terrible, terrible fire. It was arsenic used. Four people died, including a child. The city razed the building, you know, destroyed it, and put a fence around it. And we had to walk by that every day. And it was just great tragedy. It made state headlines, it was news. Everybody felt terrible. So for 2 years, I walked around, literally looking for a lock that we could build a building and raise money for the kids. And one day, a parent, dad came to me and he said, Linda, I know we want to build a building. You know, what about where the fire was? And I had a wall of emotion. I immediately, having heard this many times before, said, it's not big enough, you know, what? And he goes, but a child died there. Wouldn't you like to replace tragedy with hope? Oh my God, still, this is, you know, 23 years ago. I saw that, I went out, I swear, there's like flowers coming up here singing. You know, I've been seeing the whole thing in complete light, and I went, holy shit, where have I been? You know, this is exactly where we need to go. And from that, got invited to go to the city to make a presentation about could we get money to actually buy the land. The city gave us the land, and then we had to pay a little bit for the taxes back, and then the money started coming in. And 8 nonprofits, we were in the paper, people heard about it. It's going to be a child and family place where a child and families die. So all of a sudden, all this publicity started generating this amazing vibe. And we raised $1,200,000. And it was simple. In a way, it was very difficult, it was a lot of work. But it was simple because people came because they were attracted to the healing. And they loved it. And one of those programs was the brand new program called the Make Time Dollar Network. Which is now our exchange program 20 years later. So never ever underestimate what's right there, what the opportunities are without money, because the money just kept coming. And in fact, at the very end we built the whole building, 12,000 square feet, 3 stories, and the construction company that won the bid actually was a man who had graduated from the neighborhood and made good and said, I want to give back. The architect lived down the hill, and so he put his price down because he wanted to do it. And we opened the building up at the end and said, we'd like to invite the community in to help us. So we saved all the highest part of the money that cost, which is the painting and the finish work. That's where they make the highest profit. The construction guy said, I'll let you do this, you know, so because you guys really invited the community. So we invited people to come. And hundreds of people came and painted the whole thing. It was furnished by the community. Banks donated. Banks love to get rid of furniture. It's ridiculous. They change it every 6 months. We got all new furniture, offices. Other places gave us chairs, tables, kitchen. Everything was donated. We saved hundreds of thousands of dollars to make opening up and saying, we're in this together. So go be it together. Thank you.
Thank you.